Paso, everyone. This is Bree, and this week we are headed to Con, and so we won't have another video out today, which is Tuesday, which is our usual post day, because we'll be recording our panel on Friday, and we'll be hosting that just raw and unedited, so you guys get to see all the craziness. I have been sick for the past week, which is why I haven't been super active or even done really anything with this account. You can kind of see my lymph nodes are still swollen. That's why you need to get your tonsils removed if you have tonsillitis as a kid. Just kidding. Listen to your doctor. Blah, blah, blah. So, fun story with this video that I'm going to do. So, a while back when making assumption videos was relevant, we were like, oh my god, we're like, it's so cool. And so, we had all of us put our assumptions on our Instagram, and then we screenshotted them all so that way we could, you know, see what they say and do a video of all of us together. Wow. I can't remember who, but I know two of the Presto members no longer have theirs. I think it's Michaela and Brenna, because Michaela ran out of space. Oh, I just called her Michaela. I just dead-named Michaela. She's going to be so upset. She's going to be like, oh my god, you're dead to me. Anyways, so Kayla has no space on her phone, and she screenshotted Brenna's for her, because Brenna was with her little sister getting her nails done anyways, blah, blah, blah. Brenna wasn't getting her nails done, Riley was getting her nails done, fine. So they no longer have theirs, so we can't really do a video about it together, but I was like, you know what, this is my first time, I'm gonna dye my hair by myself, and so I might as well take you guys along on the journey while doing the assumption thing, so we'll see how it goes. You can see that I've just got like a lot of green going on, which is actually what I was going for initially, but the blue stuck way more, so, oh my god, you can't even really tell the green on camera. I just need to always be on camera, and no one can see me in real life. So I'm going to do that and answer the assumptions. I totally forgot to grab a glove and Vaseline my face. So if you ever dye hair, Vaseline in your face just makes it so you don't become a blue little smurf, which, you know, happens quite a bit. I might have to go grab that because, like, honestly, I don't think I can. I cannot risk being blue. People at where I work will destroy me, rip me to shreds. They'll be like, why are you blue? Because my hair's already blue and, you know, social deviancy. Okay. We're gonna go on a trip to go get the Vaseline. You're gonna watch me rub on my face. And I'll start answering some of these super sweet assumptions. Let's go on the trip while I go grab my Vaseline. You get to see our messy house. We're still in the process of Con Crunch, so we haven't had any time to really focus on cleaning and cleanliness because, you know, why is that like a priority? It's not here. Yeah, it is. I like cleaning my house every day, but, you know, sometimes things get in the way. I wonder if Aquaphor will do the same thing as Vaseline. I mean, it'll fill my pores. Let's go for it, right? I bought it for my tattoos, and it's expensive. So it's gotta be great on my face. Okay, so we've got this. I need to grab gloves. Because, you know, we're a professional hair dyer area. Hair dyer, hairdresser. It's fine. Words are hard. Oh, it looks like I just passed a person. Spooky. Okay. If someone interrupts me randomly through the video, it's Patrick. He is seeing the girls in our garage currently, which is fun. Okay, so the first assumption is it takes a while for you to get into cosplay. Well, actually, I would say, this is me tooting my own horn, but I am probably this is gonna get me roasted. I would say I'm one of the faster people to get into cosplay because I have like characters like Dobby, who, you know, you think I would be, like, the last one done, but Sam is a prima donna. Love him the most. So it takes him 6 years to get into cosplay, which is fair. I don't blame him. And so I would say that it doesn't take me super long. I think I get in pretty quickly. However, if I, like, focus and I try to do, like, make my eyeliner sisters, then that's gonna be a couple more years added to my makeup time. So yeah, no, I'm gonna say it doesn't take me a while. I'm actually pretty good at being really fast with that kind of stuff because I'm like, okay, just like it just has to look okay, you know, it just has to be perfect. I don't think I've ever done like a perfect makeup look for any of my characters. So maybe that's something I should have worked on personally. Another one says, just a beautiful bean, and that's really sweet. You guys get to see the pretty sides of me. So, you get to see the beautiful bean part. I'm a good friend. That you're a good friend is another assumption. Which is, I would say, pretty true. I do try to go out of my way for the very few friends I have. And it's not because it's like, I'm like, oh man, no one just gets me or likes my personality. I am very, like, shy naturally. If you met me in person, you wouldn't guess that because everyone's like, oh, you're an extrovert, blah 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 blah. No, I literally like I have what I call a work face, and so I'm like, oh yeah, like I'm gonna be right up in your business. Hey, haha, let's have a good time, party, party. But like when I'm at home and I don't have to do anything, I literally don't leave my house. I am like, I'm a homebody, and so it's like, no, I don't want to hang out. No, I don't want to keep like text you back. I am the worst at texting back. Anyone can vouch for me that knows me in real life. Even the fellow Press Tour members and Amber would say, like, agree. Probably, I work harder with both all those people because you know they're important to me. But even then, I'm pretty shitty still. You are legit the least straight one in the group. I don't even, well, probably, honestly, because everyone else in the group is either pan or bi, and so I am just a full-on lesbian. One day, if I do fall in love with someone else who's not a girl or Amber, I'm not gonna hold myself back if I fall in love with a guy. But currently, and as far as I can see in my future, I am straight up into Amber and girls. Like, that's it for me. Sorry. Foxy Twinner says, I am the attractive twin, and it's so true. Have you seen this face? I am the gorgeous one. Okay, I have to go to the next page, because these are all screenshots. You like mangoes. I freaking love mangoes, except when I eat them in the back of my throat. It creates a weird feeling, which is, you know, probably means I shouldn't eat mangoes, but I love it. That nerdy wannabe says, you're in love with Kayla, and I don't want to admit this on camera, but oh, it's so awkward. We're just gonna skip that conspiracy theory. Okay, here I go, starting the dye process. I'm so nervous because I don't even have a mirror. I need to get a mirror because I literally can't see. Okay, I'll be right back. It'll just take me a second. I'm not gonna unplug. You can look at my Vanny, who's just sitting on the arm of the couch like a freaking monster. Oh, look at our messy couch. What is in front of me? Oh, it's a text bubble. You guys can't see that. Okay, perfect. I've got my mirror. I'm gonna be looking down a little bit. Oh god, that's not gonna... Oh, shiz. Okay, that's better. It's that way I can see. If I'm looking up to the corner, that's why. You're the least overdramatic. I would say that our group... Like, we make fun of Sam for being dramatic, because he kind of is. And it's fine. That's what he's always been known for. Frick. This is gonna be so hard. I'm gonna screw this up. But I would say that it's a pretty good... Oh, I started! Oh, no. Okay. Okay, it's fine. This area doesn't even need to be dyed. Why am I wasting my time on it? But, yeah, I would say I'm one of the least dramatics. But, like, you know, everybody has moods. So I'm gonna say that if I get into a mood... I, like, literally can cry over stupid, stupid things. Like, I don't cry over, like, necessarily sad stuff unless it involves dogs. But if it's heartwarming, like, I get really close to teary-eyed. Like, a lot of scenes in Fairy Tail, I don't know if any of you have watched Fairy Tail. It's so good. I recommend. It's on its last season, but it's long. So it's not like you'll be starved for content. It's run forever. But, like, they have so many heartwarming scenes where I'm just, like, wanting to bawl my eyes out. So, I mean, in a sense, yeah, I'm not as dramatic in some ways, but, like, I'll cry. I'll sit down and bawl. Okay, sorry, that one was a long one. That you have adorable cosplays. Thank you, you're so kind. I think that you're props, the one who always wants to do something, the motivated one. Well, that is, I am pretty darn motivated. Like, I'm always like, come on, guys, let's do something. I want to make the most out of my day, blah, 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 kind of thing. And so I would say that I am, yes, I'm very motivated. It's tied probably between Brenna and I. Brenna works a little bit more than I do. She has a full 40-hour job where she gets yelled at by people, so sometimes she does need to come home and just fold laundry and watch Fairy Tail, and so I don't blame her. She probably right now is the most motivated to get into cosplay all the time. Because, like, I stand around and run around in my job and interact with people, so sometimes I'm not really wanting to, because I'm like, I've already done this kind of all day, and so I don't really want to work on that. This is a 9-minute video. I need to get going. So yeah, I am very motivated. Someone says, you quote memes nonstop, and that is 100% true. I am always, like, quoting crap. I don't have the best memory, so my quotes are often incorrect, But yes, I quote memes are my like kingdom. I am someone who always wants people to laugh. I'm always trying to make jokes and make light of situations and just like generally, I just love laughing and I love hearing people laugh. Like Amber has such a cute laugh, so I'm constantly trying to make her laugh. So yes, I quote memes all the time to the point where it's almost obnoxious. A lot of the Abridged series on YouTube for animes, I don't know if any of you have seen them. But like 50% off to name one, like the Dragon Ball Z Abridged. I've never watched Dragon Ball Z, but I've watched the Abridged series plenty of times. The vegetable's my favorite. But yeah, memes nonstop. This is not needing to be a long question. Why am I making it a long question? Someone says that I'm the mama bird of the house. That is kind of true. Brent and I both really do take on that parental role because we want to make sure that our little youth, Sammy, our little brother, and his our basic little sister Kayla are happy, and then our little sister Riley. We want to make sure everybody's eating and everybody's like really taken care of. But I literally go by the dad of the house. Like I'm the space dad. We do a fake Father's Day kind of thing. Well, it's not fake. It's real. 100% real. We do Father's Day for me. Brenna's the mom of the house. She's known as the mom of the house. So she's, you know, my bitch. It's totally good. Totally fun and fresh. You are the one feared in the group, but in a good way. So I would say that, Brenna is dead. Look at how terrible this is turning out, guys. My hair is gonna be dead. If you see me at Con Rip, wish me luck. I would say that Brenna, I am definitely gonna jump and be crazy. And like, I'm definitely first to be psychotic, I'd say. But Brenna's the one who intimidates everybody when they meet her. Like, oh no, I got some on my forehead. Oh, good lord. Okay. Oh my God! Oh, don't do this at home. Don't do this by yourself. Oh, dumb ideas 101 by Brie. See, that's why I put it all over my face. Oh my God, why am I doing this? Oh no! Oh, it's just making it worse. So yeah, Brenna's the intimidating one. Everyone, when they first meet Brenna, she's like, everybody's scared of her. Kayla will even tell you about that. Maybe we should do a how we first met Kayla because like, the poor thing, we were ruthless. But Brenna was worse. So I'd say that Brenna's the one who's feared in the group, not the or even Sam, just because we're like, you know, no, I wouldn't say Sam. Everyone like gets along really well, and when they first meet Sam, they're like, yes. He, however, holds people to a really high standard. So to me, I get intimidated by that because I'm like, I just want Sam to approve of me, and he does. It's never like he's like, oh my God, you're an idiot. Well, probably right now. I'm probably gonna get that right now when they get home, and they're like, what the frick is wrong with your hair? Okay, let's see. You are so cute and lovely. Oh, thank you. Someone else says you are chaotic evil, and I would 100% agree. Almost. I've always like this is stupid, but I've always identified in the that realm. You know, like oh, lawful good and whatever. I think that's for Dungeons and Dragons. I've always identified as chaotic good because I'm like, yeah, I'm crazy and I will do fucking crazy shit. You've all seen it. Oh no, my forehead's. Oh, I'm making it worse. Guys, I'm gonna be stained for gone. This is the worst. Oh, I hear rubbing alcohol works. I will do that. I have isotopal alcohol. Not because I was lighting my hands on fire. See, this is what I mean. Chaotic. I've always been chaotic, good. But I took one of those tests and it told me I was chaotic. I mean, I was true neutral. And I'm like, neutral my butt. Like I definitely see life as like do whatever, do your good, do the most good you can. And so this is terrible to say, but sometimes I just think that the rules that are set aren't necessarily good for the individual, or you know, necessarily just the best. They worked in the times that they were created. They are no longer relevant to what we need to change them. So I think that yes, rules are good, and but I think your own moral set is what really leads you and shapes you. Oh, this is gonna be such a disaster. Like this is not good. This isn't a rule that I would follow. I'm gonna just go ahead and skip all the compliments, not because I don't love them. I cherish them and I have them screenshotted on my phone, obviously. I think it's really sweet, but just because having me just go, oh, thank you, the whole video would be interesting. And it's already 14 minutes long. So then someone else says, you're confused about my sexuality. No, I am definitely not. I am 100% confident in my sexuality. And honestly, like, how it all started for me is like, I was like, oh, I'm straight, you know, everyone has that as a kid. They think they're straighties because that's the standard, that's what we set the default to. But then as I watched Parlay Productions, I fell in love with two of the people who identified as girls at the time. And so, but then after one of them came out as trans, I was still in love with them. And so I was like, crap, what does that make me feel? So I was just always like, the pansexual mindset. Like, I just like what I like, and I'm going to be happy with it. I still hold that to myself now. I don't like labels, so I'm always like, I just like what I like. But I definitely, this lesbian is one label I can get down with. Okay, let's see what's that. Your hair is short because you're a dom. Okay, well, we're not going to talk about this one. We're just going to move on with our lives. You're secretly dating Zac Efron. Frick no. I know Zac Efron is not Ted Bundy. I get that 100%, but I watched the Ted Bundy series, and I hate Ted Bundy with a goddamn passion. So I can never look at Zac Efron and be like, I'm just, like, here for it. Like, this is who I want to be with forever and for the rest of my life. Let's see. I'm outgoing. No, I am 100%. I am, like, a 9,000% introvert. Okay, now it's time to do the back of the hair. Oh, this is so scary. Okay. Shoot, sugar honey iced tea. I'm just gonna rub the shiz in so bad. So I am not outgoing. I've already kind of answered this. I really do wear a customer service face super well. I also do it when I do the cosplay thing and like YouTube thing, because like I really like I love people, but I'm not very sociable. I find my best times when I'm alone. By alone, I mean usually with the group. Or Amber, but I like am the most creative by myself. I really don't reach out to people in my own set, just not because I have a disconnect with people, but just because I feel like I really just find myself happier as an introvert. I have 20/20 vision. That is the farthest fucking lie in my life. Oops, I said fuck. I have some of the worst vision. I have to wear contacts 24/7, and it's a huge funny story about my contacts that maybe one day I'll tell, but this video is so long already, it's 17 minutes, so I'm not going to go into that. But I have terrible vision, so I need glasses or contacts 24/7, so I actually don't take out my contacts when I sleep because I hate not being able to see. So when I go to bed at night, I want to be able to see right when I first wake up because I'm easily afraid and I get spooked and I'm like, if there's a ghost, I want to see it! You know, or someone breaks into my house. I want to be able to fight them off. Someone put down that I'm funny, and yeah, I'd say that assumption is true. I'm funny looking. Just kidding. I laughed at my own joke. Oof, that's awkward. So this video is gonna make me cringe for the rest of my life, but that's okay. Okay, everyone, I've got my hair dye all in. I'm just gonna squeeze the rest of these yummy juices onto it and rub-a-dub-dub, so that way I can make sure I at least got everything covered. Oh my sweet Jesus. That just got everywhere. Okay, we're done with that. We're done with the tubing. I have to raise my thing up. Art Spree says, you have an addictive personality, a nice butt. Well, that's a lie. I stuff my butt every time I get on camera. Every time a picture's taken, I stuff it with old newspaper and Taylor Swift albums, because that's how I handle my life. Okay, now it's in. I have to let it set. I am going to answer the rest of these questions as I'm waiting, and you guys just see my ugly little blueberry head. Oh my god, I'm a nuna. Let's see, what's another going? Oh, someone says that finding out you were queer wasn't a big astonishing moment for you. It's just like, ah, okay, which is really, really accurate. Because like I explained before, it's always been just like, you know, I'm not going to limit myself to whatever label says that I should be. That's how I feel about gender too. But it's so I just came home with, I will maybe tell the story in depth. I came home one day after the craziness of high school, and I was just like, oh, by the way, I kissed, no, I think Alicia was over. The person was over. Maybe I should beat that. So I came home, and I was like, I had my girly friend at the time. I don't know if they identified that as a girl, but I had my friend over with me, and I was like, oh, by the way, this is my person. We kissed. Wild times. And I had, actually, in high school, I had kissed a couple girls before that moment, but, you know, YOLO. You kiss the mirror for good luck. No, but maybe I should start doing that. Just like, how you doing? Good luck, baby. No, I think I need more than luck at this point. think I need a hairdresser. You like pistachio ice cream? I've never tried pistachio ice cream. I need to because I love pistachios, but I just think those two things don't mix. You put milk in before the cereal. No, I'm not a goddamn monster, but maybe I'll start so that way I fit into your stereotypes. Someone else says that I am really busy, and that's 100% true. I am someone who has to be moving and going at all times of the day. Like, I can't be sitting down. I don't do the relaxed thing. So when I had to take a day off and sleep, it, like, destroyed me mentally and emotionally. It's like, the next day it was, like, jitters almost. Like, I was an alcoholic who just got had been, like, sober from alcohol for a little bit. And I was like, oh, shit, I need to do things. So, yeah, I keep myself insanely busy. I look at life like a schedule, and I'm like, I always have things that I need to schedule in. And so, yeah, I just try to be busy because that's where I'm happiest, is busy. So that's kind of lame, I know. Another lot of cute compliments. Thanks, guys. Works out? I do. I'm a really active person, and I like to go to the gym quite frequently. And when I don't, I get really antsy. Like, I like gym. I go on walks every day now that it's, like, warmer, because here in Idaho, we get to, like, negatives. So I have to wait till it's warm. But, yeah, I like to go on walks every day. So I do work out a lot. I would kiss somebody for $20. No, because kissing strangers is super awkward, but I also have a girlfriend that I'm very much devoted to, so I would not kiss anybody for any amount of money at the moment. The one who plans most of the videos. So this is kind of tricky. I do all the editing, and a lot of the times I will, like, we all put in our advice, like, what should we do for this scene? But it's all, like, what's the word it's called? It's all improv. So everything just goes crazy. So yeah, I put in a lot of ideas, but so does everybody else, you know? So we, like, try to make it equal, but I definitely, like, would be the one before when we actually wrote scripts. I would write the scripts kind of thing. So yeah, kind of accurate, but, like, also we all do our own thing. I try to take care of everyone, but I'm definitely the dad of the group. I am not the mom of the group. People keep thinking outgoing. Bree is not a nickname. My full name is Brianna, but it's like a dead name. My name is Bree. Please do not call me Brianna. Sometimes I mention myself when I'm talking in third person. I'll say, oh my god, Brianna, what are you doing? Like, and get myself in trouble that way, which is kind of weird. So someone else says that I'm highly energetic, and that's very true. I have a lot of energy. I'm just like, I really am just a moving person all the time. Someone else says you're a savage. I actually try to live my life in the nicest way. I try to be nice. Like, that's my goal. It's just to make everyone happy. So no, I'm not a savage. I can be really, I am a little bit confrontational. So I can go up to people and be like, okay, what the frick is going on? But I literally don't want someone walking away from a conversation that I've had with them and feeling down. So even when I become savage, in, like, that sense, once I've hit my limit, I always apologize because I want people to learn and grow, but I don't want it to be in a mean way. So I always am like, my goal in life is to be the kindest kind of person that I can be. Someone else said, you like hanging out with people? 100% freaking lie. Someone else is assuming is rude, and that is true. You shouldn't make assumptions about people. Yeah, damn assholes. No, just kidding. It's true, though. You don't want to judge a book by its cover, so way to go, person. Loud yet helpful. That's very true. I'm a very loud person. My voice is naturally quiet, but I am definitely like, wah! I try not necessarily be the life of a party, but a chaos starter. So yeah, I get loud and I look like Manetta. So I'm gonna just keep doing Manetta. Oh, someone else says you like anime. Yeah, that's 100% true. I don't watch a lot of anime, but I do watch a little bit of anime. I'm in it for the boobs. That's my Manetta. That's not me. Honestly, I'm a bot person. You're the one who's always on their phone checking. That's probably stats. No, I hate phones. I hate phones so much. However, once I do post a new YouTube video, I'm always like, oh, what are the comments? I want to read them. Yeah, we read all your comments. So next time you call my mom a whore, please just know that I read that. JK, JK. I do a lot of voices. Ah, someone said you're a bottom as an assumption. That is so damn rude. I'm not going to address this either because it hurts my feelings. So we're going to skip that. That you'll just start singing or something. Yes, but when I start singing randomly, it's not like how, you know, James Charles just bursts out in the songs like, oh. Yeah, mine's always a freaking joke because his voice ain't made for singing. So if I'm singing, it's because it's fake and I want someone to laugh at my pain and my inability to sing. You always have been beyond plus ultra. Thank you, guys. Very hyper, very kind of true. I'm not necessarily... Wow, three workaholics. I am definitely a workaholic. I find happiness in working and creating. So yeah, I'm a workaholic. I give 100% 100% of the time. So even when I'm at work or when I'm doing drawings or paintings, I'm like always like, okay, this is gonna be freaking perfect. And so yeah, I have energy, so I go ahead and run around and do as much as I can in the least amount of time. Time efficiency is something I look forward to. Look at how purple I am. This is disgusting. Someone else wrote, you are secretly an alien. And so I just, no, I'm not. Of course not. I'm not an alien. Just don't look at my shirt. It's not like I'm, no, I'm obviously, why would an alien wear an alien shirt? Ha ha ha. Woof. Okay. Wow. I just skipped a bunch. I'm sorry. You get, here are my lips. You have a crush on BNHA fanatic. I do not. I think they are an amazing person. I have a crush on Amber. I think Amber is fantastic. BNHA fanatic is someone who I really admire and I think is such an amazing person. Like 110% want to be their friend. They're so cool and they draw like ridiculously well and it hurts my feelings how well they draw. No, just kidding. I'm just like my fragile ego. They can draw so much better than me. So yeah, 100% want to be friends though. Like friend crush, yes, there. But Amber's my boo. So she has 100% of my romantic heart. So sorry. You like pineapple on pizza. I don't like pizza, so no, not necessarily. Okay, so there's a couple pizza types I like that taco pizza, 100%. Like, I'm there. I love any type of Mexican food, though. So you make pizza Mexican food, I'm like, I should say Spanish. It's not just Mexico that does it. So Spanish food? I don't know. But yeah, so pineapple on pizza doesn't really change much for me. Still don't like pizza. Has absolutely no chill. You're damn right! I have no chill. Actually, my tonsils are still sore, so I shouldn't be like this. A bro to hang out with. Yeah, I'm definitely, like, that person who's like, okay, guys, but, like, what? Watch me parkour. And then I'm, like, gonna fall on my face. It's a good time. We have a lot of fun, and I create a lot of chaos. Sorry. Just very gay. Just very true. Very gay. You scream all the time. Yes, I do scream. It's a problem. Probably that's why my throat is so freaking bad right now, because I've overworn it. You can see my lymph nodes still. They're like a second little bump on my throat. It's kind of fun. It makes me think that I've swallowed two large beetles and they're just right there. Ida. Yes, I am Tenya Ida. I want the purge. No, I'm just kidding. JK, JK. No, we also... So that one says, whoops, I'm like answering without even responding to the question. but it's like, did you start Presto Productions? No, it was a mutual thing. We got in contact with the Snake River Fandom Con coordinator. I don't know what Tangle did. Tangle did so much, so she was freaking crazy. But we got in contact with her, and we're like, oh my god, let's do an Attack on Titan panel when that was relevant. And so we did, and that's kind of when we were like, shit, we need to like have something together for this. And we all wanted to create a group, so we were like, okay, let's start Presto Productions. And so that was kind of where that came from. And I think that's it for my, oh my god, guys, holy crap, I finished my assumptions, and now I will have my hair done. I will try to post a picture of it when it is done, so you guys can see the new glory of how much I effed up my purple, look at that purple forehead, guys. I'm not gonna be able to pull myself back from this. This is why you don't do this alone. I am purple everywhere. Oh, this is so embarrassing. Hopefully Rubino will get it off. Okay, guys, I will keep you updated, probably just with a picture and a post, because I don't want to have you wait, because I have to keep this stuff in for 30 minutes. And I'm not going to make this an hour long thing. I've already answered all my assumptions, so I can't even really do that. Okay, guys. Peace out. Have a good rest of your day. We will talk more after Fandom Con, and hopefully I'll be 100%. And these lymph nodes will go the frick down, because I'm sick of having two beetles on the side of my throat. Manetta is out. Have a good one. Bye.